streets of 1815 and 1817 East Franklin Street for the purpose of a multifamily dwelling with up to 13 dwelling units upon certain terms and conditions.
Good evening, Mr. President and the Council. I am Matthew Ebinger. I'm the Chancellor of the Acting Principal Planner for the Nation's Administration and the Acting Planning Secretary to the Planning Commission. This ordinance is reference to a special use permit request that was made to allow conversion of existing warehouse buildings to 13 multifamily residential units. The zoning of the property is now one light industrial, and so a residential use is not permitted without some sort of special approval. The major issue at hand surrounding this application is the issue of windowless dwelling units. The Planning Commission passed a resolution on June 4th, 2012, under the title for use to promote provision of adequate light and air, and in so doing to both eliminate to the extent reasonably possible the existence of windowless dwelling units and to promote utilization of operable windows in the renovation of historic buildings. It goes further to define a windowless dwelling unit as a unit that does not contain a window that penetrates the exterior wall of the building. And two of the units in the plans associated with the special use permit are considered windowless. Unit 102 is a two-level unit consisting of a bathroom and windowless bedroom on the ground floor and a living area in each on the second floor. Unit 105 is a one-level second floor unit. Both units are certified skylights and door windows approximately 14 feet from the floor. But there are no windows that penetrate based on the walls of the units. Overall, the proposed project shows 12 one-bedroom units with a range of square footages from 522 square feet to 736 square feet, and one two-bedroom unit of 861 square feet. The Planning Commission met on February 4th and voted 6-2 to recommend denial of the proposed special use permit based on their belief that the plans are not in keeping with the resolution, and furthermore would compromise the added provision of light and air, which would violate one of the city charter's conditions for granting special use permit. I'll go further. There are certain allowances in the resolution for windowless units, but it does specify that those are to be avoided at all costs, and it is in very specific situations when a windowless dwelling unit would be the only way to prevent the building from being demolished or lost. In other words, if the only way of preserving this building were to have windowless dwelling units, then they could be permitted at that time. But that is only if the National Park Service and the Virginia Department of Historic Resources determines that such windowless dwelling units are necessary for the continuation of the building. And in those cases, the square footage of such units should be at least equal to or greater than the average square footage of the total number of units. And in this case, one of the proposed windowless units is above the average square footage, but one is below the average square footage. So even in this rare case where the units were necessary to maintain the building itself, they still do not meet the square footage provision of the resolution. Looking for the background information, since 2005, there have been over 200 units that were approved that did not have windows as part of the historic rehabilitation project. The Planning Commission saw that as a negative trend, and so passed the resolution as a notice of sorts to the development community that windowless units is not something that the Planning Commission would support. And we have recently received information that the National Park Service appears to be changing their opinion as well and is giving some indications that they will not be supporting windowless dwelling units. We haven't received any specific letters or official policy changes, but information is appearing to lean in that direction.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. At this point, is there anyone speaking in opposition to this paper?
Virginia, I'd like to speak in opposition to these two proposed apartments without windows. There are skylights in permanent, but I think every human being has a right to fresh air, and, you know, you don't have access to fresh air if you're just breathing through a ventilation system that's prone to contamination, and people should have windows in where they live. So, you all talked about following the advice of the Commission on Architectural Review earlier. I mean, you heard that the Planning Commission recommended by vote 6-2 against approving this. You know, you'll probably have people speaking in support of this, like the architect and the developer. They have financial stake in this. Support the Planning Commission. Vote on this paper. They can go back to drawing board and do it all over again. Thank you.
Others should speak in opposition. Those who speak in support, please.
Good evening. My name is Walter Arps. I'd like to thank you all for being here this afternoon at 9 o'clock, and I hope you have a little energy left. If you look around the city, Christian, there are a lot of great things. The reason there are a lot of great things going on. Absolutely meets the requirements of life.
just wanted to be clear in terms of the passage of the provision that includes this type of apartment that we now are clear that not we know that they have a very different type of lighting, not the standard. This is Cass Lynn and Monty.
June 4th, 2012.
And this is the first paper to come forward, or project to come forward since that contract. Okay. And you've looked at the development, is that correct? And the only issues for you are the two units that do not have what they call the timber lighting served through the wall or out to the side, is that correct?
Steph also had a concern with the lack of commercial space on the first floor of the building. It has a commercial storefront designation. However, the Planning Commission did not believe that to be an integral part of the building, and so did not have concern with the lack of commercial space in the building. They focused only on the lack of windows in the two units. So that was the primary concern, and I believe the only concern that the Planning Commission expressed was the two units that did not have the windows in each kind of wall.
And we do have allowances for windows in the two units.
Under very specific circumstances and the way the resolution is written, it seems to be driven more by DHR than by the applicant.
Thank you.
Just one of those noodles.
Yeah,
just
one of those.
That's absolutely fine.
We've had opportunity to hear both from the Planning Commission and as well as Land Use, who reviewed this and may have moved it forward without recommendation at this point. In terms of the two units that are in question, did you have a conversation about any options or opportunities to keep them in any way that might be more consistent with what is being asked?
From the time we went to the Planning Commission, we increased the size of the window that originally we were doing to have at the dormer occupy where the former skyline was. At this point, I mean, we doubled that to what's required. To get to a point where we can get a window through an exterior wall, I've got buildings there. I'm just
asking you if anything had happened subsequent to the Planning Commission and the answer just went back to the large. And did you share, was that after planning or before land use or after both? And did you hear that?
We did, coming back to talk to staff about that, they didn't feel like it met the requirement. They were fixed on the idea of windows to a wall.
But you did make adjustments to those in the union.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any other questions, Dr. Mueller?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Comments from, and I think that would include the question and answer period. Comments from other city council members?
In the units that rather small, the pond on the top that I have here, so forgive me, but could there be a reconfiguration or expansion of the units such that the windowless units would be helped in other units? I guess you ended up having 11 units. Is that
in terms of that sort of the technicality, in terms of the, whether you want to use light air, the units as they are assigned, read light air. If you would create a larger unit, we create less desirable air. The market doesn't really want that kind of unit in that place. The units we have down on Reynolds, much larger units, it's a different market. I'm asking for flexibility to define the window in a broader sense. If you look at the dictionary definition, it's going to say, an opening constructed in a wall roof. You can scroll through a bunch of them. There are many definitions. The definition that we have right now is very limiting. And so I think you get to that definition, but it doesn't create a better product. And what we're really after is a better product, a better place for people to live. And that's what I mean.
Thank you, Mr. President. The ordinance is written relative to light and air. It would seem to me that the sun, the skylight would provide the light. But what I'm concerned about would be the fire safety of that. And I'm assuming that the property has passed the fire code on that. I hope that it would have, but I'm concerned as to how a windowless unit would meet fire code. I mean, while the skylight is certainly providing you a lot of light to get out of the building through it would be pretty impractical. So if somebody could just say that those are in compliance with fire code, that would be
I don't want to speak completely to the building code, I'm not part of that division, but my understanding is this resolution not in the past if the building or fire code would have prevented those units. I believe that there are other fire safety measures in place that a window is not necessarily required for your building or fire code.
Maybe Mr. Parks could call the table and ask you.
With a sprinkler system, with two means of egress, two separate exits, different directions of the building, absolutely needs the fire code. Any kind of house building, same sort of idea. Two exits, sprinkler, you don't block the windows.
Right, you have an exterior, I guess, masonry. I mean, it's materials, the sprinkler system, and your evacuation, which are the three criteria whereby somebody can survive fire.
Exactly.
But you've got the sprinklers covered and some materials in the building are not planted.
Exactly. Everything is protected with firewood walls.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Other comments by council members? All right, let's call the question. Yes, Dr. Hugo?
I think what I'd like to offer for consideration here is the fact that, number one, this is a long-standing big building in an area that we are looking forward to revitalize. The size of the units are inconsistent with the population. It seems to be really happening in various students, and the old person is not necessarily families. Those kinds of things, so it seems to be pretty consistent. What's in question here are two units, and we have been adjustments to those units such that we do have the skylight and we have the dormers, and even if you want to split the window, we can do this really, you'd be looking at the wall. The paper was passed June 2012, so we have a lot of these units, actually, in this group. City. And while I'm not advocating for also continued construction necessarily the size of these features, I would suggest that in this instance, this is an opportunity to bring the building back into functionality assume that those rooms don't open, correct?
They are operable. The resolution the planning commission passed is not to find window, but it defines the window as a dwelling unit as a unit without windows penetrating the external wall. So the planning commission determined that the skylights and more specifically the dormer windows are not considered windows penetrating the external wall, meaning that the vertical plane of the dormer is not considered an external wall of the unit.
So a window will only be a window. If I'm doing old and star tax credits, am I allowed to change the outside of the building like that and put in windows?
Generally not. I mean, probably the architect would be more so what do you generally
do? I'm not sure if you missed parts of this, but I've seen some things where windows could not be going in.
There are other projects similar or under similar situations where there are brick walls potentially that DHR would not allow that ability to cut into. However, again, it seems that they might be changing their viewpoint on windows, and so I'm not sure how that would come together.
Thank you.
Are there any other questions for this gentleman? By council, this is the last call for questions, right? Doesn't happen now. Mr. Ashmont.
The basic question that I'd like to have answered is, has every possible resolution been sought? I mean, with the planning staff and Mr. Parks here, you know, we just sent back the car appeal and the homeowner to try and work it out, and here's another example of where the staff and the property owner to work it out. In order for that to happen, we would have to send this paper back to planning,
which is not without precedent, but it has been rarely done. I'm not interested in starting that kind of precedent tonight. However, I'm willing to hear from Mr. Parks about his client's desires as far as they go with the length of decisions.
That we've been hearing this evening aren't in fact in the paper that we'll be voting on. And in order for those, I think you said that we were going to get an extra 5 feet of windows in each unit, but without a revised plan being approved, then we're voting on the plan that has fewer window square footage.
That's my understanding. Is there any other comment by city council members? Seeing none, please call the question.
Council spoken on item number 28, ordinance number 2013-4. Mr. Bowers?
No.
Ms. Graziano?
Yes.
Vice President Robertson?
Yes.
Mr. Alvarado?
No.
Mr. Mueller? Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Dr. Newville?
Aye.
President Sims?
Aye.
That paper has passed.
Thank you very much. Please move to the next item on our agenda.
Yes, that will be on the regular agenda. Item number 32, resolution number 2013-R48. Thank you.
Thank you.